There's a lot of things I've learned over the years, and I just wanted to share a little bit about some of the things I've learned. And I asked to do a presentation, and some of the stuff that I've learned over the years, I've had to really pick and choose what I was going to show everybody. So here I'm going to try and demonstrate at a very high level, just kind of touch a few high points, and then maybe over the years dig a little bit deeper each time. But for now, it's just going to be kind of a high-level overview of some things you can do to get some efficiency out of a few things in Solid Edge. So I guess I should just go to the next slide because this is really where I want to get to. My name is Cory Goulden. I'm an application specialist with designfusion. We have a very large office, I think. We have an office in Toronto, which I'm based out of in Canada, two in Montreal, one in Chicago, Pennsylvania, and one in Calgary. But if you've seen the Weather Channel lately, Calgary kind of demos and dinghies because they're all underwater, so they're under about 15 rows, and the hockey arena is underwater right now, so they're having a rough time. But anyways, so I've been using Solid Edge for about 15 years as a customer. Okay, I've only been doing this reseller business for just over a year, and in those 15 years I started on version 5, not ST5, but actual version 5. So I'm pretty long in the tooth with Solid Edge, I guess. So some other guys have been around just as long, but seen some exciting changes. Synchronous, I've watched it grow. I was an alpha tester for Synchronous. It's pretty exciting. First day on the job after I got out of college was working at a rail car manufacturing plant. They took a 2D CAD system, where a lot of people, instead of changing the line work, like to just change the numbers. And engineering got blamed for every single thing under the planet. We went to Solid Edge, went to 3D, and I was getting yelled at repeatedly by shop guys who were saying, this fits, it's great, I'm happy, and the engineering guys are yelling at me going, why are you changing these numbers? We've done it for 20, 30 years, and now all of a sudden you're telling me you're changing it? What do you know? You're just out of school. So you go through the numbers and you find out that things were inherently wrong over the years, and it saved my previous employer probably hundreds of thousands of dollars just by going to a 3D system. Solid Edge and that company, I managed to take it from all the way from not just in manufacturing engineering, jig and fixture design, template design, offline robotics programming, CNC pipe bending, and nesting and burning tables. So Solid Edge has been extended that far in that company, and I kind of ran out of things to do, so I joined designfusion upon the offer to go to different companies and see what other companies do and see if I can help them out. So that's what I'm going to attempt to do today, is I'm going to show you a little bit of what I know, and hopefully it'll get you guys set up a little bit better back in your offices. So what I'm going to go through right, in this little session is I'm going to talk about something called the SEAdmin tool. Has anybody ever heard of the SEAdmin tool? Has anybody heard of it? Does anybody use it? Okay. So I'm going to show you how I have used it and, touch a few points, and then hopefully you'll be able to take it home and get more out of it. So, and we're going to talk about company-based themes, customization, the templates, dimension style mapping. Did anybody use dimension style mapping? Yes? Okay, a couple. Okay, so there's a few things. Something else I want to mention too is in ST6. So I'll back up a little bit. My job, what I do is I don't usually do demos of the software. If you're a customer of ours, you call the tech support line, you'll get me or another group of guys that are the technical specialists, and we'll answer your questions. So when I hear a lot of calls about some challenges people are having, that usually brings something up to either post a blog article on our website or do a presentation such as this. And the one thing that I've been having a lot of calls on recently is the Windows UAC setting. So when you install Solid Edge ST5, if you don't have UAC off, you get into a big mess, right? You have to uninstall Solid Edge, you have to clean the registry, you have to turn off UAC, install all of this stuff. So in ST6, what they've done is they've actually created a preferences folder. And these are all the files that you're going to be able to change or modify, and they're in a designated folder so that you don't have to worry about securities and turning off UAC anymore. That was a big clapping moment for me when I can install Solid Edge and not have to mess around with UAC. Some customers are not allowed to turn it off, and that's their prerogative, but now you're able to do that. The skill level of this, it says intermediates, but I mean, it really could help everybody out. You know, a lot of companies don't have the liberty to have a CAD administrator. They'll have somebody who's a designate, or they've just won by default and they get to do it. So here's a little slide about the preferences folder. You've always had delivered data files that can be customized or modified by the user. They've always been in a Solid Edge program directory. Windows Security doesn't want you to have them there anymore. They want you to have them in a folder that's designated so that it's able to be changed and modified. So with additional securities in Windows, it becomes problematic with UAC if you don't do this. So they've taken the files such as any files that you use for translators. If you hit File Open in Solid Edge and you select a file, SAT, the Options button lights up, right? And it kind of changes you make in there are made and stored in these any files. So those are all in your preferences folder as well. The little gotcha here that I think is kind of important is your selicense.dat file is now in that preferences folder, okay? If you're ever going to be, you know, if you're the type of company that puts your license file on the PC and it's always been under the program file, now you have to put it somewhere else, okay? So just be aware of that in ST6. So now we'll dig into the SEAdmin tool. But before we do that, we have to take a look at creating some modifications in a template, right? So let's talk about a template, and then we'll talk about how we go on from there. So normally at a company, you would set up your templates. You tell everybody to use your templates. Everybody agrees on one style, and things are going to be good. The problem is it doesn't always work that way, right? I've had calls from companies where they wanted something a little bit different. So here's the Solid Edge program files, ST6, and now you have your preferences folder, right? So that's where that'll be. So in here, you'll have all these, you know, your link management file, your config names, folder maps, if you use Insight, a whole bunch of things, and there's your SE license file. So sometimes at a company, you'll get a bunch of people doing a bunch of drawings, and they have their own styles, and everybody wants to do things in a different way, and it's not really productive, right? You have people to report to, and sometimes you don't get the consistency you need, and you're spending a lot of time doing things that you really don't. So you'll be doing things that you really don't want to have happen too much. So. What's going on? Sorry, guys. This is something's happened to the slideshow here. Okay. Okay, so here in this example, right, this is a regular org chart. I had to come up with an idea of presenting a scenario, but every time I tried to pick a company name, it was so close to somebody else's company name. I didn't want anybody getting mad I was talking about them, and it wasn't. So I made up something pretend, and I know there's no such thing as a Justice League of America drafting services, okay? So let's just hypothetically talk about the fact that Aquaman here, he likes to have a certain style on his drawings. He always wants it to be aerial, and he always wants his, you know, letters to be a certain way. Green Lantern here, he always wants the text to be in green, but he agrees that it should be in aerial, right? And the Flash, he always wants everything in italics, right? Moving fast. But they all report to two people. They report to Superman, who wants everything to be in bold, and Batman, who wants everything to be in Century Gothic, right? But they all report to the boss. And the boss should make a decision and say, guys, this is what we're going to do, right? But the CAD administrator comes along and says, I got an idea. He says, bazinga. So what we're going to do is we're going to allow you guys to have your personalities at home. You can wear your personalities on your sleeve, but everybody's going to be the same. We're going to adhere to the same rules. And then you start having a little bit more consistency, right? Everybody starts looking the same and doing the same thing, and then you're efficient. You end up doing your job instead of messing around, spending so much time trying to tailor to somebody's personality instead of getting your job done. Okay? That's pretty scary. So you can see there's some consistency here. So go back to this one. I think it's just because I'm doing a split screen. So now what, you know, all joking aside, what we really want to do is we want to have some consistency. We want to create a draft template, for example. Right? Draft seems to be the one that sticks in my mind that you want to have the most consistency with. Drawing is still king. There's still, you still need to get this message to the shop. You know, in my experience, it's pretty important to set these things up and have your styles. So in this example, we're going to talk about setting up a drafting template. So here I have Solid Edge opened up, and all I've done is I've taken installed Solid Edge out of the box and just added a little logo on the background sheet. Nothing fantastic here. So I said new draft, started it, put a little picture on the background. I'll go into my styles here. And in my styles, I'm going to create a new dimension style. And the reason I'm doing this is just to show you guys I'm not doing anything magical. It's just kind of step by step, okay? So I have my dimension style. Has anybody messed around with dimension styles at all? Everybody have templates set up? Yep, okay. So you're all familiar with this, so I can skip through this a little bit faster and I'll spend more time on some other stuff. So I have created a dimension style called Company ABC Linear, and I've got one called Company ABC Diameter, okay? I've set these up. And in here, you know, I've gone through and I've changed my parameters. So I've changed it to aerial. It was the one thing that all those guys in the, you know, the Justice League of America drafting services agreed on, right? Democratic society, everybody says aerial except for Batman, he loses, okay? Let's agree on one thing and do it. The other thing I like to mention since I'm here that's helped me over the years is organizer. Has anybody used organizer? Okay. So if you're not familiar with what this is, organizer, you can go in and I can say I want to browse and I'm going to select a template that I've already created. So in this one particular example, you can copy a style. I'm not even going to go through it because it takes a bit, but you can browse and you'll open up a draft file per se, and it has certain styles in it, and you can copy them to your draft file that you have currently open. Okay? So that way if you change styles later on, it's a good way to kind of bring those changes over. Anyway, so I have Company ABC Diameter and Linear. I have these created in my template. All I need to do is save this somewhere. I could save it anywhere. I could save it on my hard drive. I could save it on a network share. But really what you want to do is put it in a location, a designated folder, right, that's called your company's name, templates. Okay? And then when you put it there, you'll give read access to everybody, except for the administrator, okay? Let the administrator be the one person that can modify files in there. That way you can lock it down and be consistent with what you're doing. So now you have a draft file. You've saved it in the proper location. We've created some customizations. Now when we go into, I'll minimize this again. Now we go into the draft template. Why should we have to set a dimension style every time we pick a different kind of linear element, right? It can be a radius, it can be a diameter, it can be a straight line. Solid Edge has something built into it called Dimension Style Mapper. And what that is when we go into Solid Edge, you can go into your Solid Edge options here. I apologize, the dialog boxes are popping up on the other side. And what you have here is dimension style. So what I've done here is I've created those two styles we just talked about. One was linear, one was diameter. Now inside of dimension style mapping, I tell Solid Edge my options, use dimension style mapping, okay? And I've said for linear dimensions, I want you to use company ABC linear, right? That's the style I've created. I've also created one that I'm going to use for both radial and diameter dimensions, okay? And you can go through this, and you can also set things up in a drawing view style, and you can set up cutting plane lines, so if your section lines need to show up a certain way, you also go through the similar setup I just showed with dimensions. And here I have a style called cutting plane line. But let's just stick to dimension style and the dimensions. So I'll go through and go into my sketching, and I'll create a one of my favorite commands, the rectangle by center. I'll create a circular element, and also create a little radius in here just to show you guys I'm not full of baloney. So when I pick on my dimensions, you'll notice something right away. The ability to use the drop-down is blocked out, right? And that's because I've said solid edge use dimension style mapping. I can override this on the fly by just turning it off and on. It's no problem, okay? But I've set it up already. So now when I pick elements, right, I'm getting my dimension style that I've selected. So everything is doing exactly what it's supposed to do. So you see it says company ABC diameter up here when I'm placing it. It's giving me feedback telling me that it knows what I'm doing. Now you'll notice it changed to linear. Okay? So in this example so far, I've set up a template to provide consistency. Now I'm using dimension style mapping to get a little bit more efficiency out of it. Okay? Now, we've got this happening. So the next step is to go in, and now we're going to say, okay, well, I have this template defined, but now every time I say solid edge, file new, I also want that to be changed a little bit. That way it's more efficient, right? I don't have to go exploring for these things. So I go back into my solid edge, and I'm going to go back into my solid edge options, and under my file locations, you have user templates. And you'll see here in this example, I've modified what was there. I said instead of going to the regular solid edge folder, I've created another folder somewhere else. I'm not hooked to a server, so I can't show you server setup. But at your company, it would be best to have it on a server location, right, like I mentioned before. And you just point this at those templates. And that way, if there's any changes to your templates, it changes in one place, and everybody gets the change, right? Something to note, though, if you modify where these user templates are, there's a little bit of a gotcha. You need to go into here and edit your creation options. You'll see here I've gone through already. I modified my default draft location or draft template to be this ABC draft that I just created. And the displayed name is J. Lode's drafting template. That's American Justice League of America Drafting Services. I figured the acronym was better than typing that all out. The other one you want to make sure you have set up is your default templates. And here I've gone through and done the same thing. So just kind of remember to go through and do those two as well if you modify the user template location, because those are used when you're doing your file opens and you're translating things. Some other stuff happened. There's dependencies in there. It's just easier if you go through. I find it's you can either do that or you can reset your just go back to the file locations, or you can reset this user template. Right? If I've modified something, I can always go back and reset something. So now let's take it a little bit farther. So now we've had a draft template saved on a server. So let's start talking about the SEAdmin. Okay? I need to have something set up. So we got this little guy, he's the designated SEAdmin. The first step you're going to need to do is you're going to need to go to the install DVD. I said CD, but that's because I got a problem with moving forward, I guess, with the CD, DVD. Copy it from the install CD. On the install CD, you have a file called seadmin.exe. You're going to need to copy that to the program directory where you install Solid Edge. And here I found it to be a bit of a long path, so I believe these presentations are available after. So you can download them, so there's a little note on there. You guys can download it and you'll have the path set up for you. But it's typically under Program Files, Solid Edge, Support Tools, SEAdmin. You got to copy it to Program Files, Solid Edge, ST6, Program Folder. It has to be there. And then the best thing to do is probably put a shortcut to that on your desktop so you don't have to use File Explorer to go all, digging all the way back in there and find that file. that's how I like to do it. Feel free to do it however you feel like it, but that seems to work out pretty good. And then you start the application. So I will escape out of this for a second and we'll do a little bit of a demo. So here's my shortcut to ST6, SEAdmin. And I get this option the first time because I haven't opened it. So now when I open this box, the dialog box, it gives me a plethora of things I can control. Okay. So now what we're going to talk about is I'm just going to talk about the fact of a few of these things. Some of these tools are in here for Insight, some of them are in there for Team Center, but a lot of them are in there to help you control Solid Edge. So the first thing we're going to talk about is user templates. Here I've set a location. Okay. You'll notice there's two columns, allow override and value. So do I want to allow an override? No. Everybody in my company is going to use this template and you're not going to be allowed to override this setting. When you say file new, I want you to use this, right? You're getting consistency. Everybody has to play by the rules or get out of the playground. But there's a few other things that are kind of interesting in here as well. The one thing that was mentioned before was your the new ability to use YouTube. Okay. Some companies don't want you to be allowed to upload to YouTube. And to control that as an administrator, it'd be much easier to do it at a high level. You can still create videos and save them locally, keep them locally. There's no problem. But I don't want you uploading company secrets to YouTube. That's for sure. So you can go in here and you can say, no, I don't want you to be able to upload to YouTube, right? Or I don't want you to be able to override this value, but I also don't want you to be able to upload to YouTube, okay? That's how you would do something like that. I think it's a great tool, but it's also great to know that you can control it, right? So there's no worries there. Material table. Sometimes you have a customized material table. Maybe you should have that on a folder somewhere. Maybe you should have a folder called Solid Edge Files, and then under it have Solid Edge Templates. Have another one under there called Material Table. Then you can have your company-defined material table. That way you can all share. There's a lot of things you can share in Solid Edge and set up. So, you know, you can do those kind of things very easily. But as you can see, this is a very long list, and I'm not going to go through it all because I want you to be awake at the end. But reports, right, your bill of material settings that you'll have for your draft files. Set it up once, put it on the server, let everybody share it, okay?
Can you edit the
panels
out there?
Yes. Yep, yeah, absolutely. If you wanted to modify it, you just double click into free space and it brings up your browse to folder options. It's pretty simple, yeah. Okay, so now we've got SE Administrator set up. It's on our computers. Not everybody needs to have SE Admin. Only the admin needs to have it. So you don't have to copy it to everybody. Just do it to your designate. He's got control, she's got control, whoever, right? Then you save this file, and you need to save it to a network share. The reason why it will give you an error if I tried to save this right now because I don't have a network share hooked up, and the reason is because I would never use SEAdmin for one person. It doesn't make sense, right? It's going to say you need to save this on a shared path or folder, but that can be done. It asks you if you want to save the file if you make modifications. Now inside a Solid Edge, I'll go back to the PowerPoint for a second here. Oh, great. I lost my place. I apologize. So here's in this slide, if you download the PowerPoint, I've made sure that I took a few snapshots of all the options just in case you're perusing and you're curious about it without having to do all the work of installing it. But you can go through and you can see there's the user templates. You know, some other things you can control in here. There's the gotcha for the edit creation options, right? Yeah, and also it can affect, if you don't set those edit creation options and set default templates, it can also affect the mirror command in assembly, right? The older style mirror command. So here's the screenshot of that. Now what I'm going to do is I go into Solid Edge. I go under my file locations again. And there's this dialog box if you've never used SEAdmin before that's been there for quite a while, but if you've never utilized it, we're gonna talk about it right now, okay? All you'll need to do is click on SEAdmin, go and find that options.xml file that you just created. So that when we had SEAdmin open, it opened the options.xml file, okay? And when it said save, you can save it as whatever you want. So you can have this set up so that you use it for a company, a department, small group of users. You can use different options.xml files. You just name them different things. When you go under your solid edge options, so we'll take a quick look here. So when I go to, under my SEAdmin, you hit modify, and it brings up, it says, which one do you want to make? And here's my options.xml file. But you can see in this example here, if I had three different options.xml files with different names, you can select which one you want to use. Okay, if you want to control departments at a time, okay, we can do it that way too. So once you have that, it's here. If you make changes to that options.xml file, instead of having to go making changes to everybody's computer one by one, I can go to that user's computer and I can click it and I can say update. Okay, and once I update it, all the changes that I had made inside of that options.xml file are propagated into my solid edge settings, okay? So I don't have to do it one by one to everybody.
Is that generated if you close out a solid edge and come back in, does it do the update automatically?
No. No, it is. It has to be invoked. Might be a good enhancement request, possibly, but usually what I found is you do it and you can test it on one user and then you deploy it to everybody else. So you find that one guy that's usually your pretty good guinea pig that gives you good feedback. So yeah, see here it's changed my company templates. It's changed everything that I had. If I had set anything up separately, sheet metal gauge files, user templates have been modified, so now it's not the solid edge standard default, right? It's to what I want it to be. And if you say I don't want anybody to be allowed to change this, that modify button will be grayed out. Okay, so you can lock it so that they're not allowed to change it from whatever you set up. Seems to be particularly useful when I was working with Insight a lot. Does anybody use Insight here? So what you can do is you can set your folder map and your search scope in here, and it's done. So you don't have to pick it every time. You don't have to, you know, every new version and everything like that. Your options.xml file, you can migrate it from one version to another, right? So that all you have to do is click on it, say, modify your SEAdmin file, hit update, and those things will change for you. Pretty useful for Insight. Yes?
If I got multiple users and all everything is the same except for, say, your proxy file,
yep.
Would it be better to leave that one as being not modified to the admin page of each individual computer or have a new options one for each user?
No, I would do that. I would leave that one as a modifiable field in your options. When you pull up the SEAdmin, it opens your options.xml. I would leave that one field, allow override, and you set it to yes. So if you change it to that, they can change it to a different prop seed file. Yeah. So now let's talk about, so that's the SEAdmin file. At a very high level, there's a lot of things you can do, pretty powerful. The other thing that I find that a lot of users don't utilize is this, the ability to customize the ribbon and toolbar layout. And I bring this up because I don't think people understand it as twofold, and there's some changes that have happened in ST6 that make it even better, but typical location in Windows 7 is your C drive users, username, app data, blah, blah, blah. That whole path, okay? I'm putting it here so that you can find out where it is, and if you go to migrate to the next version, ST7, you can have a backup of these files. Okay, if you use a company standard delivered out of the box, what I found, I used to have to manage over 50 users daily. We had 35 floating licenses of Solid Edge, and sometimes it would be more than 50 people, but they're doing all kinds of different things, and they customize their menus, and usually what I would do for the engineering department was I would have the engineering department customization. I would have that set up, okay? Then when I upgrade Solid Edge, I put those customizations back in. If they wanted to deviate from there further, at least I gave them a leg up, because I found that every time we went to a new version, my engineers would be sitting there for about an hour, hour and a half each, customizing their menus again to put them back to being efficient. So recently they made a change that now you can go into your this directory, and once you have that set up, you can copy it onto a file serve. That way it's backed up as well. That's another great thing about having them on a network share, is everything gets backed up as well, right? So you can go into, you can create a new customization for a company or department. So once you have a base determined for the company, it's a good starting point, but you can go further. So the thing is here is once you go in and you customize anything, you know, I have company standard number one here listed, but then I can go farther from there. I can use that and build another one. And I can say this is a user standard. This is Corey's standard. This is not the entire company standard. So when I have that, maybe I messed something up. Maybe I don't like it. Maybe I want to put it back the way it was. All I have to do is use the drop-down list and pick back here and move forward from there. Okay? So let's take a quick look at that. So inside a Solid Edge, I can find my mouse. So here I've gone through my edit creation options, and there's your Justice League of America drafting services template. I can also pick on new, and there it is right there. Okay, this is all because I've set up the SEAdmin. When you set that user defined location for your templates, this user tab pops up, and anything that you put in there is going to be present, right? If you ever need to get back to the system defaults, you just click on more. So I go into Solid Edge. I have a synchronous part model open. Everybody knows if you double click the tab, it'll give you more room. If not, there's a good tip. I seem to like it this way. This is how I like to work. I just use this drop down. I go into customize. Solid Edge is aware that I'm in the synchronous part modeling environment. So I can go in and I can say, okay, I want to use company standard number one. It changes everything that I've done. If I flick back and forth, you'll see some of the radial menu changes. But maybe I'm a unique user. I don't ever want to use Pan because I've got one of these cool 3D controllers. Maybe I'd rather utilize that for something else. So I'm going to inspect. I like to use Inquire Element a lot. So I just drag it over and drop it onto something and it changes. Okay. Say Save As. I can say Corey's Theme. And I can continue to customize and drop a whole bunch of things on here. Maybe I do something I don't like and I've realized, hey, this is not a good thing. I want to change it back. All I have to do is flick it back. Yes, I want to save changes so it knows there's changes. And I can change back and forth quite easily between the customizations. Okay. Once you set this all up, you can go from version to version in Solid Edge and have your customizations go forward. I don't know if any of you guys found this to be a problem earlier on, if you've been using Solid Edge for a long time, but that used to be a real big problem for me. I found that this is a much better solution. So,
can you push those radial menus from one environment to another?
No. No. Not that I've investigated too much. I'm sure there's probably what you call a hack and whack way to figure it out. But I haven't figured out a way to do that yet. Yeah. Yeah, you have to have an XML editor to do that, and that's kind of, if you forget one syntax or you accidentally delete a comma or a quote, then the whole thing goes pretty crazy. Yes? Yes. Interesting you should ask, because, do I have this still open? What I did was, I kept this kind of on purpose, so when I was going through the update training, they had ST6 available, 32-bit only. So I had ST6 on 32-bit, and I uninstalled it, and I didn't do a cleanup. I just left it to see what it would leave behind. So it did leave behind my preferences that I had set up. It didn't wipe those out for me, which I'm not sure if that was how it used to work, because I don't remember it being left behind. But those are all stored under your user locations. They should still be there, but it's under a different folder. Don't ask me how I remember this either, because I amaze myself. It is a very long path. So there's your different version settings, okay? So 105, if you customized anything, some other stuff in there. There's version 106. There's my company standard number one, Cory's theme that I just made. So we'll leave those behind. That's kind of the intent, that it's outside of Solid Edge. It's under your app data stuff, which is where UAC Windows Security wants you to put it, right? So we can go through, you know, this, and yes, you can go version to version, which is pretty good. So here it's, these versions can be migrated between versions. I've listed the path again for you, so you can get back to it another time if you need to. SE is only uninstalled and a new version is installed. The settings will be migrated automatically, okay? You're a pretty smart crowd, you're asking questions and you're stealing my thunder before I get to my slides, but it's okay, we'll roll with it. So most of the time you would uninstall Solid Edge, you probably do a more thorough cleanup after. You don't necessarily need to, but if you uninstall it, the new versions especially, if you install the new one on top, it'll pull those settings in for you automatically. The new nerd term, right? Automagic. Yes, it'll pull them into the new one. It'll highlight anything that's new between versions. So you'll notice on my screenshots that some of them are in orange, and that's because it's trying to highlight to me that something's new in this new version, and I have to dig down to find out where it is in case I want to get to it. But yeah, it does. I rolled through that pretty quick. I did this about 10 times already, and it never went that quick, so I guess I must be really nervous with all these people in here. I don't know. I did have some bonus material here, so let me see if I can take a moment and just no, I can't do it while the slideshow's going. Sure. Right.
And those didn't seem to be rolled into the older, like if you brought a part that was generated in an earlier version. And now with SD6, they said there's another display theme for.
I believe that what they're alluding to with the new display is the optimization of the OpenGL changes that have been made with video card drivers. I believe that's what it's about. It's not necessarily new rendering theme, but it makes more efficient use of the rendering engine that's enabled through OpenGL and the video graphics card driver. So when you spend your money on a graphics card, this is kind of a common question. I'll just throw it out because we're on the subject. But you can go and buy a gaming video card, but the gaming video card does not have a few things in it. One thing is the development of the driver itself is not suited for CAD. You're going to get a lot of crashes. Yeah, you'll save your money on the video card, but you're going to spend that money on wasting an engineer's time by all the crashing and problems that are going to happen. But the other thing is, the video card itself, Solid Edge wasn't fully utilizing the OpenGL acceleration that can happen in there. I think it was at version 2, and now it's up to version 3. So that's where it makes more efficient use of the rendering. Yeah. That OpenGL will give you better performance. So that's why you could get away with using a lower end graphics card, because it's more efficient use of the hardware and software that's there. So the driver and the video card itself, because it's more efficient, it makes everything a little bit better. So you can get away with something a little bit less.
Okay.
That's what I believe it is. I don't know if I'm speaking out of turn because I don't want to steal any of those guys' thunder, but as I understand it, that's how it is. Yeah. So I had this prepared that I might possibly run over. So I said, if you've, you know, I have the superhero theme going. So if you manage to stay awake through that, here's some bonus material because you survived the evil villain death by PowerPoint. So some other things that I'd like to talk about. Reports. I mentioned reports. When you go through and you want to set up your bill of material on a solid edge draft file, usually I find that a lot of people don't make efficient use of sharing that back and forth, right? So you can go through, set up your reports in solid edge, and those reports are in your, let me just close this part file, and inside of solid edge, your file locations, you have your reports folder. And the reports folder has a few different things in it. When you're, pardon me, working in solid edge and you have some saved settings, you know, you have predefined hole conditions, slot conditions, you know, that drop down list you see all the time. If you have those set up, a lot of those are saved in the reports folder. Okay, if you have something set up, you know, maybe you have a certain punch size that you always use, and therefore in solid edge you have a predetermined slot size, then you can use that in reports and share that with everybody. You can control that with SEAdmin as well. Another thing, Geometry Inspector. Has anybody used Geometry Inspector before? One, two, few? The thing that I really like to use it for besides inspecting geometry is if I import 2D geometry from, say, AutoCAD or somewhere else, you get a DWG or a DXF file, and you open it up, and maybe you copy and paste it into the part environment, but now you have a bunch of lines and no relationships on them. If you use Geometry Inspector, there's a tab, you can apply relationships to those lines. Okay, there's a certain tolerance in there, and when you go through, let me just kind of show you, I'll just see if I can do a demo on the fly, which you're never supposed to do in the real world. So I use my radial menu to be efficient, right? I don't need to go to the top half the time. So I can start drawing a bunch of lines. Actually, I'm going to change it to ordered mode just to make a little bit better of a demo out of this. So I'm going to sketch on this plane. In solid edge, when I'm drawing lines, I just can't see it. It's really hard to see those relationships on there. So some other things that I found is, So under my IntelliSketch options, I like to have this option on for a little bit more efficiency to automatically create dimensions for new geometry, but I usually set it to only when you key in a value. Does anybody use this? Yes? A couple? Yeah. So what this does is, if I have a line, right, you'll notice that none of the dimensions were drawn on there. But if I say I want this to be 150 millimeters long, and I hit enter, when I place it, it puts a dimension for me. Okay, I find that to be pretty useful and pretty time-saving. If I go through and delete everything except the lines, you have to give me a bit of forgiveness. I'm trying to use my mouse on the slope surface here, and it gets away from me at times. So I inspect, right? Everybody knows about their relationship colors. Turn them on. It tells you if everything's good or not. My relationship assistant, drag a box around it. I have options to place geometry on relationships, okay? And here's your tolerance. I can place dimensions if I want to. That's off and on different times. And place it, and there I've got dimensions. So if you think about that, if I was to take 2D profile from a 2D drawing, bring it into solid edge, drop it in, slap some relationships on it, you can even place dimensions if you'd like, away you go, constrained. But even better, you just throw it in synchronous. You don't have to worry about it. So that's if still have to know a few tricks when you're in ordered mode. Yeah, prop seed file uses. So does everybody use prop seed file? Who does? Who has a customized macro to do this stuff? You're lucky guy. So I don't need to go through that because everybody's doing a good job on that. Assembly display names. So when I'm in assembly, the other thing that I like to do to be a little more efficient is sometimes you'll go through, I don't know if this is going to work because I wasn't planning on a test file for it. But you can go through in your solid edge options. And at the bottom, you'll see this document name formula. And what I find a lot of people doing is your file name is actually a number. It's not a description. And the number doesn't do me any good because I've got a dinosaur brain and I can't remember a whole lot, right? So numbers don't mean anything to me. But if you have your prop seed file working and things are being populated, what you can do is you can go in and change your formula. And what I've done here is I like to leave it as file name and I give it a space or a space, dash, dash, space, just to provide something else, and I can add title. So if your prop seed file gives you a title of that file, put it in there, and then when you're in the assembly, it will actually show you the document number, dash, dash, and then that property seed file name. So when you're in there, if it says, you know, widget number one, cog number two, it'll give you your file number and that description after it. I find that to be very useful myself. Okay. Auto dimensioning we just talked about. Link fix up utility. I'm not going to go through a demo on that. I just like to mention that if you have, I get a lot of tech calls on people asking for help on fixing their links. There's a link fix up utility. It's very useful. You can go into a spreadsheet and organize your stuff. Does anybody use QuickSheets? That's not enough hands, guys. Okay, QuickSheets are awesome. And it's not uncommon. It's not uncommon. This is why I wanted to try and put this on. But if you have a quick sheet, right? Solid Edge delivers a couple of them to you, but you can go through and do whatever you want. In the test drive, you'll see a lot of. You can even have Windows Explorer open. Let me see if I can just grab a quick file here. Screen limitation here. I'm just going into the training folder. You just drag any part onto a drawing and it starts creating the drawing for you depending on what you put in there. So if you have the companies I've seen and the companies I work for, I've seen that a lot of the drawings have the same views and the same orientations and it's repeated. So what you do is you have a drawing with those views on it. You can say create quick sheet. If you go into the help files, it'll give you step-by-step instructions on how to do it. But once you set up that template, so it's a template, right? But it has this predefined views on it, and you just drop the part onto it, and it'll put that geometry in those boxes and that orientation to that scale for you with a parts list if it's an assembly. So there's another way you can get another leap forward on productivity and consistency. Thank you very much for attending. I really hope everybody found something useful out of this. Thank you very much.